Today I'm gonna show you how to install GIMP 2.10.18 version and BIMP aka Batch Image Manipulation plugin on your macOS device using MacPorts. And in this tutorial I'm gonna walk you through the entire process step by step. Keep watching. What is going on? My name is Doudou. Welcome to another video tutorial, and this time we will be going through the installation process of GIMP using MacPorts. If this is your first time here, please go ahead and start now by subscribing and clicking the bell so you don't miss my next videos. Okay, so back to our main topic, which is installing GIMP 2.10.18 version. As you may know, GIMP is available as a standalone installation package that you can download to the GIMP official website. However, you can only download 2.10.14 version. If you're asking about the major differences between these two versions, well, with the 10.18, you get a new 3D transform tool which will help you change the perspective of a layer or panning it in 3D space, plus some more improvements for PSD file support and some more bug fixes. So let's get to work. What we will be installing here is MacPorts package and then the GNU coreutils package. Those are the basic file, shell and text manipulation utilities which are expected to exist on every operating system. For this tutorial, I don't have any MacPorts installed, and to check this, I just type port space version in my terminal window. As you see, command not found, meaning that I don't have it installed. Next thing you need to do before installing MacPorts is to double check that you have the Xcode package installed in your device by typing command in terminal window xcode -select --p. If you get such path, then Xcode is installed. Otherwise, if you get empty result, then you should first install it before you go with MacPorts. For more info, check this video tutorial from the top right corner. Next, back to your browser. Open up MacPorts website, then go to installing MacPorts from here. And select required version based on your device. In my case, Catalina. Click to start download. When completed, double click on it to install it. Close the window when it's done and move installation package to the bin. Now, type port space version in your terminal, and here I get the latest version installed, which is 2.6.2. What we need to do now is installing coreutils. In your terminal window, type sudo space port space install space coreutils space pcre. If required, type your password and hit enter. I'll speed up the installation part to save some time. Here we go. We got our prerequisites ready, and now it's time to install GIMP. All you have to do is typing sudo space port space install space GIMP space plus quarters. You can actually leave off the plus quarters if you prefer GIMP to run in the Xcode environment instead of the native OS graphics. If required, type your password and hit enter. I'll speed up the installation part to save some time. Then, you have to add the GNU tool to the default path. Open your path and copy-paste this line at the bottom. Ctrl X to stop editing and Y to save your changes. Now we can close our terminal and let's check if the app is installed. Voila, we got GIMP 10.18 installed in our macOS device, which is basically the latest stable version compatible with macOS devices, and it's working just fine. Let's run a small test. I will try to open an image and let me go to document. Oh, and actually, if you got such access denied notice, you can fix it by going to system preferences, then security and privacy, and from privacy tab, click the lock to make changes, provide your password, scroll down to full disk access, and from these options, scroll down to GIMP app and make sure you check this to allow GIMP app access in your folders. Quit and relaunch GIMP app to apply new settings. You can see here that GIMP now got access to files and folders. Start again the GIMP app and let's try. Yes, now we can access our folders and files. I will open an image and here we go, it's working just fine. Alright, so now that we have installed GIMP through the MacPorts, let's start installing Batch Image Manipulation plugin. To do so, go back to your browser and open up plugin's main website. You can copy paste the link from the description text below. From here we can go straight to downloadable sources. As you can see here, we got the latest version of BIMP, which is this 2.4. Click to download the source code as a zip file. Once completed, go ahead, double click to unzip the file. You will get this nice looking folder full of other files and subfolders. Then we have to open this folder in our terminal app. Click on your right mouse button, scroll down to services, a submenu will show up. You will see these two options, new terminal tab at folder or new terminal at folder. In case you don't have them, you can enable this from system preferences, keyboards, then from this menu select shortcuts, and from the selections highlight services, and from the right window scroll down to files and folders, and finally from here make sure to check these two options. With this you can open your folder directly on your terminal app. There are also other ways to open folders in terminal, but this is the easiest and fastest way. Now that we are inside main plugins folder, all we have to do to install this BIMP plugin is typing down in your terminal make --make install, or you can copy paste it from the description text below. This command will check the plugins file and issue the commands to recompile all of them and install the plugin to the right location. Wait for the installation process and here we go, plugin is installed. However, we can see that there are two warnings. This is caused by the plugin directory, which contains a space in its name, in our case application support folder. The copy command has failed to process. Therefore, you will need to do this manually. Just as the error suggested, let's copy this part and paste it back in our terminal. Hit enter and we are done. To double check that the file is copied correctly, let's access application support folder and look for the GIMP folder. Here it is, the BIMP plugin file is copied correctly. We are ready now to test. Let's double check, open up GIMP again, check from file, and voila! We can read here Batch Image Manipulation. Click to open it, and here we go, plugin is already installed. You can see that all the plugin's features are here, and everything seems to work. This is it guys for this tutorial. If you know any better solution on how to make BIMP plugin work on macOS devices, or if you have any troubles making it work with this process on yours, please do let me know in a comment below by adding hashtag Askdoudou following your comment. I will get back to you as soon as possible. By then, thanks again for watching. My name is Doudou and I will see you on my next video.